Good morning, my brothers and sisters.
早上好，弟兄姐妹们。
平安，
平安。
So I'd like to begin by sharing a story about an unusual thing that happened to someone.
我来跟各位分享一个小故事。
Now, there was someone who had came back home from after a long day of work.
有一个人称他经过一天的辛劳之后回到家。
And when this person came home, she saw something very unusual.
当他回家的时候，他看到一个很不寻常的事情。
She saw her dog's head sticking out the side of the house.
他看到那狗从他的房子旁边的头伸出来。
And apparently this dog's head was stuck inside of a dryer vent.
这个狗的头被卡住了。
You know, no matter how hard she tried, she can't be able to push the dog through the hole.
不论他多么的费劲，他不能把这个狗从推过去。
And she can't pull the dog back either.
他也不能够把这个狗拉回来。
So in the end, what did the owner do?
最后，这个人会怎么办呢？
So this person had to take vegetable oil to put some area in the dog's neck so he could be able to let it out.
最后他很聪明，给他抹一点这个菜油，把它给弄出来。
You see, just like this dog getting stuck, I think sometimes we may feel that we are stuck in our relationship with God.
好像这个狗它被卡住了。同时，今天我们来思想，我们有时候跟神的关系好像也处在这种状态。
Sometimes we aren't feeling that we are growing spiritually and we aren't growing closer to God.
有时候我们感觉到我们并与神的关系并没有越来越近，我们没有向神成长。
But at the same time, we also feel stuck because I think we also don't feel like we are going farther away from God either.
有时我们，但是我们也没有感觉到我们好像远离神。
Whenever you come to church on Sunday, you don't feel like you are learning a lot from the sermons.
好像你每次来到新一天，你并没有感觉到你会学习到很多东西。
Or maybe you feel like you don't learn a lot from the Sunday school.
你在上主日学的时候，同样你也没有感觉到你学到了很多东西。
Or maybe even when you read the Bible yourself, you don't seem to understand.
当你
When you read the Bible yourself, maybe sometimes you don't even understand.
当你自己读圣经的时候，好像你并没有完全的明白。
And maybe some of you may feel like you're in danger of falling away from your faith.
好像你感觉到我有一种危险，我正在好像远离神。
You see, God doesn't want us to be stuck spiritually.
神其实不希望我们在属灵上成为一种被卡住的状态。
But if you feel this way,Know that there is hope.
当你感觉到这种状态、这种情况的时候，其实有一个希望。
God invites all of us to be in a loving, growing relationship with Him.
其实神会邀请我们，会成为让我们能够在他里面能够有成长，在他里面有个好的关系。
God provides us with a way to grow.
其实神会供应我们能够在属灵上有成长。
And this is what we'll learn as we look into our passage for today.
今天我们就来学习这一段的经文。
So if you have your Bibles, I invite you to take them out. Turn with me to Hebrews chapter 5. We're going to read from verse 11 all the way to chapter 6, verse 3.
我们来打开圣经希伯来书十一章。希伯来书第五章十一节。
And as you turn there, I'd like to say that the writer of Hebrews is unknown.
当我们来看希伯来书的时候，其实这个他作者我们并不知道是谁。
Some people say that it's Paul who wrote it.
有人说是保罗写的。
Or some people say Apollos or even Luke.
有人说可能是路加写的。
But regardless of who wrote it, we know that the people who are getting this letter are Jewish Christians.
但是我们不管是谁写的，但我们知道这封书信是给犹太的基督徒的。
Okay, so let's read together Hebrews chapter 5, verse 11 to chapter 6, verse 3. And we're going to read it in English first, and then we'll read it in Chinese.
我们先读英文的，在希伯来书第五章十一节到第六章的三节。
Verse 11. About this, we have much to say, and it's hard to explain since you have become dull of hearing. For though by this time you ought to be teachers,You need someone to teach you again the basic principles of the oracles of God. You need milk, not solid food. For everyone who lives on milk is unskilled in the word of righteousness, since he is a child. But solid food is for the mature, for those who have been trained by the powers of discernment and trained by constant practice to distinguish good from evil. Verse 1. Therefore, let us leave the elementary doctrines of Christ and go on to maturity, not laying again a foundation of repentance from dead works and of faith towards God, and of instructions about washing, laying of hands, and a resurrection of the dead and eternal judgment. And this we will do if God permits.
好，我们一起来读中文。论到麦基洗德，我们有好些话，并且难以解明，因为你们听不进去。看你们学习的功夫，本该做师父，谁知还得有人将神圣言小邪的开端另教导你们，并且成了那必须吃奶不能吃干粮的人。凡只能吃奶的，都不能熟练仁义的道理，因为他是婴孩，唯独长大成人的才能吃干粮，他们的心窍习练的通达，就能分辨好歹了。所以我们应当离开基督道理的开端，竭力进到完全的地步，不必再立根基，就如那懊悔死刑信靠神，各样洗礼按手之礼使人复活，以及永远审判各等教训，神若喜我们，我们必如此行。
This is the word of the Lord.
这是神的话。
Would you bow your heads with me as we go to him in prayer?
让我们一起来祷告。
Dear Heavenly Father,
亲爱的天父，
Father, we come before you with humbleness in our hearts.
让我们来到谦卑地来到你面前。
Lord, I pray that you will help us to know how we can grow closer to you.
我祈求主你帮助我，让我们怎么能够在你里面成长，离你更近。
We may be feeling very stuck right now.
有时候我们会感觉我们在属灵上停止不前。
We may be feeling so far away from you.
甚至我们感觉是这样的远离你。
But Lord, show us more of who you are in your word.
主啊，请你将你的话语显示给我们。
And help us to see how we can grow closer to you.
让我们能看见我们真是能够怎样更加的亲近你。
Father, we thank you. We lift up these things in Jesus Christ's precious and holy name.
主啊，我们感谢赞美你。我们这样祷告，奉主耶稣基督的圣名。
Amen. So in today's passage, we're going to be answering one main question.
在今天的经文，我们来看到，我们来回答一个主要的问题。
We're going to be asking, what are the necessary steps to grow into spiritual maturity?
我们首先要问自己，我们要成长到属灵成熟的必要步骤是什么？
And I believe that from this passage we'll see that there are three steps to help us grow into spiritual maturity.
当我们看到这段经文的时候，我们要看到有三点。
So we'll begin with the first part.
我们来看第一部分。
Read again with me, starting from verse 11.
我们来看就是第五章十一节讲到。
About this we have much to say, and it is hard to explain since you have become dull of hearing.
论到这个麦基洗德，我们有好些话，并且难以解明，因为你们听不进去。
And I guess, like at least in English, this is referring to Melchizedek.
在英文里就是看到这是指的麦基洗德。
And the author of Hebrews, he's saying that I am talking to you about Melchizedek, but it is hard to teach you about these things.
当我们论到麦基洗德，就是说我们好些话好像很难的来教导你们。
Earlier in chapter 7, he talks about Jesus Christ being the high priest according to Melchizedek.
在第七章也讲到，就耶稣是那位大祭司，是根据麦基洗德的等次。
But why was it so hard for him to teach them about these things?
为什么这里讲到这么难的教导你们这些东西呢？
The author of Hebrews says it's because they have become dull of hearing.
这里这作者说是因为你们听不进去。
And this doesn't mean that they are physically deaf and actually can't hear anything.
这不就是说他们好像他们耳朵真是听不见。
The Greek word for dull can also be translated as slow or lethargic.
这里讲到这个因为你们听不进去，原来讲到就是说好像你听得非常慢，或者是非常懒惰的样子。
Yeah, so in a sense, they are lazy from hearing.
就是听的状很懒惰的状态，听不进去。
They may hear God's word, but it goes in one ear and out through the other.
好像我们听到神的话，从这边耳朵进去，从那边耳朵出来。
And it doesn't actually reach inside of their heart.
好像没有进到我们心里面去。
And it's because of this, this is why they aren't growing in Christ.
因为这样，所以我们不能在基督里面成长。
Let us answer our question. What are the necessary steps to grow into spiritual maturity?
所以我们这个中心的问题，成长到属灵的成熟的必要步骤是什么呢？
Here's the first step.
You have to 这是第一步。
You have to be intentional in the listening of God's word.
第一步，我们应该要有一种刻意的去聆听神的话。
Now I know that during the summer and like especially during vacation time, people like to travel a lot.
当然这大家都知道在夏天的时候我们喜欢到外面去旅行。
And actually just the previous week I just came back from a trip to Virginia.
在之前我从一个有一次的旅行刚从 Virginia 回来。
And on the airplane, usually you before takeoff, you would hear something.
在飞机上，你常常会听到一个信息。
You would hear about a safety video or a safety demonstration.
你会看到一个关于安全的这个录像。
And like the flight attendants would say, "Oh, when you see the seatbelt sign come on, make sure you buckle your seatbelt together."
就讲到 OK， 你飞机要起飞了，你要把你的安全带系好。
And make sure you know where the emergency exits are in the plane.
我会告诉你这个安全出口在哪里。
Oh, or if there's a change in pressure in air cabins, the mask will drop in front of you.
如果有这个气压变化，有一个那个氧罩的这个罩子会掉下来。
Or to inflate the life vest, make sure you pull on the tabs.
或者在你逃生的时候，你怎么带上那个救生衣
？But when you are hearing these safety demonstration videos, how many of you are actually paying attention?
当你看到这种录像、这个演示的时候，你们有谁会真正的去用心的去看这个事情呢？
Well, I think a lot of us may not pay attention because we think, "Oh, I already heard this before."
有很多人说 ，Okay, 我这已经听过几百遍了，我就可能你不会很用心的去听这个事情。
I already know everything.
我已经知道他所说的。
And you know, you look around and people are sleeping or just playing on their phones.
可能你在看你的手机，可能你在想别的事情。
You see, they have become dull of hearing because they think they already know.
所以我们在听这件事情上是非常迟钝的，因为我们觉得我们已经知道了。
I think this is the same thing when it comes to hearing God's word.
这好像就是同样的事情，当我们来听到神的话的时候，好像也是这样。
Consider these statements. We are dull or lazy of hearing when we think we already heard or we actually know.
所以当时就是当我们感觉到我们已经知道的时候，其实我们可能会听的时候就非常的迟钝。
Maybe you already read this Bible story before.
也许你已经知道这段圣经。
Or maybe you think that, oh, I don't. God can't teach me anything more from this.
或者你认为神并这段经文并没有教导给我更多的。
Or maybe sometimes we are dull of or lazy of hearing because we don't actually want to listen.
或者是其实当我们干脆就说不觉得我们这个应该去听。
Or maybe when we listen, we only listen partially.
或者就是说我们只听到其中的一部分。
And then later on, you just go back to playing with your phones.
或者就是说我们又回到我们的来玩我们的手机。
See, we can be dull of hearing, which is preventing us from growing closer to God.
所以我们在听道上是非常迟钝的，这样会阻止我们在神里面成长。
Look, Romans chapter 10, verse 17. It says, so faith comes from hearing, and hearing through the word of Christ.
在罗马书十章十节讲到，可见信道是从听道来的，听道是从基督的话来的。
But the writer of Hebrews continues on and says in verse 12, For though you, by this time you ought to be teachers, you need someone to teach you again the basic principles and oracles of God.
所以在十二节里面讲到，看你们学习的功夫本该做师傅，谁知还得有人将神圣言小学的开端另教导你们。
Now the author of Hebrews is saying that if these Christians were actually listening, they should be teachers by now.
就是说如果你真正能够听真正的把神的话听进去其实你应该是做教师的
But instead, again, they have to learn the basics of the faith.
但是其实你不是你每次都是还需要去学习那最基本的东西
So I want to encourage everyone here to not be lazy when it comes to listening to God's word.
所以今天我要鼓励大家我们在听神的话上不要懒惰
Every time you come to church on Sunday, prepare your hearts and have the intention to see what God can teach you.
当我们每次星期天来到教会的时候，我们要预备心来思想神是怎么样通过的话来教导我们。
Don't think that you already heard everything and God can't teach you anymore.
不要有一种想法，就是说我们已经知道了，神好像不能够今天不能够教导我什么。
When you're at home, when you're reading the Bible by yourself, also prepare your hearts by praying to God.
当你在家在你读圣经的时候，都要预备你的心来领受神的话。
Ask God to teach you from this passage when you're reading.
请求神通过这段话来对你说话，对你教导。
Now when I pray, I ask God to open my eyes and to open my heart to learn.
当我祷告的时候，我会请求神来开我的眼睛，开我的心窍。
You know, in Deuteronomy chapter 29, verse 4, you know, it says, But to this day, the Lord has not given you a heart to understand, or eyes to see, or ears to hear.
在《生命记》29章第四节讲，但耶和华到今日还没有使你们心能明白，眼能看见，耳能听见。
Now, and this is Moses speaking to the Israelites when they were in Moab.
这是在摩西对以色列人所讲的。
So,Pray to God to ask Him to open your eyes, open your ears, and open your hearts.
所以你们，我们要向神祈求，让我们真是能够眼睛能开，心能打开，耳朵也能听见。
Whenever you approach the Word of God.
当我们来寻求神的话的时候。
Now, after we listen to God's Word, then what is the next step?
那第一步是我们要刻意聆听神的话的时候，那下一步是什么呢？
So the author of Hebrews continues on and he gives an illustration.
在这个今天的经文他继续来看到我们看到给我们一个示范。
Now from the last part of verse 12, he says, You need milk, not solid food. For everyone who lives on milk is unskilled in the word of righteousness, since he is a child.
在十二节的后半段讲到并且承认那必须吃奶不能吃干粮的人凡只能吃奶的都不熟练仁义的道理。因为他是个婴孩。
So essentially, these Jewish or these Hebrew, the author of Hebrews is calling these Jewish believers as babies.
所以这作者来把这些希伯来人的基督徒称他们为是婴孩。
You see, infants they do not have teeth.
因为婴孩没有牙齿。
They can't chew.
他们不能嚼这个。
And that's why we can't give solid food to babies.
所以我们不能给那个固体的食物给他们吃。
Or else they will choke.
或者那他们会哽住，会噎住。
I mean, that's why we give babies milk.
所以我们也给婴孩只能给他喝奶。
So just as infants will live on milk, those who are spiritually young or spiritually immature are unskilled in the word of righteousness.
所以就像婴孩他只能靠奶而存活。那我们这些长不大的基督徒也只能都不能熟练仁义的道理。
Or in other words, they're unskilled in the word of God.
他们对神的话上是不成熟的，不熟练的。
See, even the Apostle Paul had called some of the Corinthians spiritual infants.
而且保罗也称那个哥林多人是属灵的婴孩。
First Corinthians chapter 3 verses 1 to 2.
在哥林多第一章。
But I, brothers, could not address you as spiritual people, but as people of the flesh, as infants in Christ, I fed you with milk, not solid food, for you are not ready for it, and even now you are not ready yet.
哥林多前书三章一到二节，弟兄们，我从前对你们说话，不能把你们当作属灵的，只能把你们当作属肉体，在基督里为婴孩的。我是用奶喂你们，没有用饭喂你们，那时你们不能吃，就是如今还是不能。
You see, your physical maturity is different than your spiritual maturity.
所以你在这个身体上的成熟跟属灵上的成熟不是一回事。
You know, someone older than you can actually be less spiritually mature than you.
你在实际的身体上的成熟，在属灵上的成熟，有可能是比你小的。
And someone who is physically older than you can be like a spiritual infant while you are a spiritual adult.
如果甚至你的身体是非常健壮的，但可能你在属灵上还是个婴孩。
So let me ask you, where are you in your spiritual maturity?
让我们问你一下，你在属灵的诚实上，你是处在一个什么样的状况？
Are you just living on the spiritual milk and taking on the basic principles of faith?
你是不是就是只能喝奶的，只能吸收那些最基本的道理？
Or are you moving on to the solid food and deeper into God's word?
或者你已经往前走一步，能够更深入的进到神的话语里面？
Then comes the question, then how do we move on to this solid food?
所以那我们的问题是我们怎么能够往前迈进到去吃那固体的食物呢？
How are we supposed to grow more spiritually mature?
我们怎样能够让我们在属灵上更多的成熟的成长呢？
Now, the writer in Hebrews gives us a clue in verse 14.
在希伯来书在十四节里这样讲到。
He says, but solid food is for the mature, for those who have their powers of discernment trained by constant practice to distinguish good from evil.
唯独长大成的才能吃干粮，他们的心窍习练的通达，就能分辨好歹了。
You see, after we listen to God's word, we are to take it and we are to practice it.
所以当我们刻意地聆听神的话的时候，那我们应该领受而去操练。
And by practicing and applying it, we can be able to have discernment between what is right and what is wrong.
当我们来操练这个神的话语，我们就知道能够分辨是非了。
See, the difference between a spiritually immature Christian and a spiritually mature Christian is not about physical age, as we mentioned earlier.
所以这个在属灵上成熟的基督徒和这个属灵上不成熟的基督徒并不体现在他的年龄上。
It is not merely about the knowledge that you gain from reading God's word.
也不是在有你在对神的这个话上有多少的知识。
But the difference is whether someone is constantly practicing what they hear.
这个不同就是是不是你能不能够时常的坚持的操练神的话语所赐给你的。
So they know how to apply it.
是不是他们能够知道怎么能够应用神的话语在他身上？
Let's answer our question again. What are the necessary steps to grow into spiritual maturity?
那我们看到我们今天这个中心的问题，成长到属灵成熟的必要步骤是什么呢？
Here is the second step.
这是第二的步。
Constantly practice what you hear from God's word for discernment.
所以第二个步骤就是在分辨是非上，我们能够时常操练从神的话所听到的。
So something that I encourage everyone in the church to do is to actually take notes whenever you are studying God's word.
所以我鼓励你们，当你们学习神的话以后，你可能做一些笔记。
Now during the sermons, I make it easy for you to take notes because I have the bullet points. I have main points.
我已经把这些东西都打在我的 PowerPoint 上了，这样你们更容易的。
Because by taking notes, then later on you can go back to it and be able to know how think about how you can apply it.
当你们 做这些笔记的时候，你又能够翻到的时候，你就会思想把这些怎么原则怎么能应用你 到你的身上。
What does God say about how you are to live your life for him?
那神是怎么说呢？在你怎么样去过这个从神看来的生活？
What does God say from his word about who he is?
或者从这个神的这个经文上，你能怎么能看到神是什么样的？
If God tells you to love one another, then be specific.
如果神告诉你你要彼此相爱，那你应该要具体一点。
Yes, think about particularly how can you love others? Maybe you are to love your family by cooking for them.
你可以从这句神说我们彼此相爱，那我们想到具体一点，我们怎样去爱人或爱你的家人呢？
See, that's an example of applying a truth that you learned from God's word.
这是一个例子，我们怎么样把这些真理能够应用到你自己的身上。
So we should always seek to practice God's word.
我们就是一直去寻求怎么样来操练神的话。
Finally, from this passage, I believe that there is one more step that will help us grow into spiritual maturity.
还有一个步骤也是能够帮忙我们怎么能够在属灵上成长。
Let's start reading from chapter 6, verse 1.
我们看第六章第一节。
The author of Hebrews says, Therefore, let us leave the elementary doctrine of Christ and go on to maturity.
所以我们应当离开基督道理的开端，竭力进到完全的地步。
So this shows that we shouldn't always be happy with where we are spiritually.
所以这里看到我们不是总是在我们这个属灵状况是满足于现在这种状态。
We should always strive to grow closer to God and leave the elementary doctrines.
所以我们应该努力竭力完全进到一个地步呢，我们不仅仅停留在基督道理的开端。
You know, if we don't want to grow spiritually mature, it's almost as if it's an adult who's still in elementary school learning basic math.
这里好像一个状态，如果我们不往前走，好像我们总是停留在小学的这个水平上，我们总是在学习那个小学的数学。
We continue on in verse 1. Not laying again a foundation of repentance from dead works and of faith towards God.
所以在第一节后半节讲到，不必再立根基，就由那懊悔死刑信靠神。
We know that it's basic that we need to put our faith in Jesus Christ for our salvation.
所以就讲到我们最基本的信仰就是对我们的行为，我们悔改我们那些靠行为而死的东西，而我们来真正的来信靠神，因信称义。
This is very foundational for our whole faith.
这是我们信仰的一个根基。
And the author of Hebrews also goes on to other examples of basic doctrines.
所以下面还讲到有一些基本的信仰。
Verse 2. And of
第二节。
And of instructions about washing, the laying of hands, and the resurrection of the dead, and eternal judgment.
比如洗礼，比如说按手洗礼，比如我们知道死人要复活，我们知道有永远的审判，这种基本的教训。
These are basic doctrines which are foundational, and we should move beyond that.
这些是我们信仰的一个基本的教训，但是我们不应该仅仅停留在这里。
Now I know that when some people when they start to move into a new area, they're looking for a new house.
当我来一个打一个比喻，当你搬到一个新的地方的时候，你会去找一个新的房子。
And some people like to choose the option of building their own house and designing it.
也许你会选择我来建造一个自己的房子，甚至来设计一个。
And you can build a house very quickly in a few months.
你可以在一两个月就能够把这个房子给建起来。
Imagine that there is a new house being built, but the foundation is there.
所以我们来看这一个房子还没有建，但是我们看到它的地基已经在这了。
And this foundation has been there for many, many years.
好像这个地基已经在这里很久了，有甚至几年了。
And that's because the workers keep on putting up the foundation, destroying it, and keep on putting up again.
我们想象，就会人甚至把这个地基打好了，然后把这个地基摧毁了，然后又把这个地基给打好了。
So if you keep on doing it again, then the house won't make any progress in finishing.
只要我们这样做的时候，我们这个房子永远建不起来。
And this is what it's like in our spiritual life if we remain in just the elementary doctrines of Christ.
就是好像就是我们的属灵的状况，当我们常常是停留在这一些最基本的道理上。
Because we keep on laying down the foundation and destroying it again.
我们一直在不停的在建造这个地基，又把它摧毁，又不停的建造。
And it's only through leaving this foundational doctrines where we can start to grow into spiritual maturity.
所以如果我们不仅仅停留在这个地基上，我们才能够走下一步来继续把这个房子给建好。
Let's continue reading verse 1 again.
我们来第一节。
Therefore, let us leave the elementary doctrine of Christ and go on to maturity.
所以我们应该离开基督道理的开端，竭力进到完全的地步。
No, it's possible for us to apply the first two steps, but not grow spiritually mature.
也许有可能我们就是遵守了上面两个步骤，但是我们还不能够进到一个属灵的成熟的地步。
We can listen to God's word and we can apply it and practice it, but then we can still not grow.
我们可以听神的话，我们好像也可以有一些的操练，但是我们还是可能没有达到属灵的真正的成熟。
How is that possible?
这怎么可能呢？
You see, the Greek word here for go on to maturity, is in the passive voice.
这里讲到极力进到完全的时候，实际在原文呢是一个被动的语态。
In other words, by growing into maturity means that we have to allow ourselves to be carried on into maturity.
所以是一个被动的语态，那就是说我们必须要允许自己被进入、被推到那种状态。
So this shows that our spiritual growth isn't necessary by our own self-effort.
所以这里讲到我们竭力进到完全，不是凭着我们的自己的力量而进到完全。
But rather, we need to depend on God to carry us or to bring us on to maturity.
所以这里讲到是我们必须要依靠神， 让神来把我们抬到那个状态里面去。
Look at verse 3. And this we will do if God permits.
所以在第三节讲到，神若喜我们，我们必如此行。
Our spiritual growth is dependent on God.
所以我们的属灵上的成长是完全依赖神的。
Let's answer our question. What are the necessary steps to grow into spiritual maturity?
所以成长到属灵成熟的必要步骤是什么呢？
Here's the third step. Depend solely on God for spiritual growth.
还有一个步骤，就是在属灵的成长上单单依靠神。
So I know for everyone, at one point in our life or another, we have to learn how to drive a car.
我知道每个人就是我们都有一个学习开车的经验。
You can be able to practice and know how to navigate the streets from left to right.
我们知道怎么样的开车转左转右或者怎么样的看地图怎么样的。
However, you have to think about it. Your car cannot move, it cannot go if it doesn't have any gas in it.
但是你都知道，如果你的车可能动不了，因为可能是没有汽油了。
Just as gas is needed to make your car go, God should be your source of spiritual growth, even though as you listen to His word and even as you apply it.
所以就是说，神是车汽油能够使这个车往前走。所以就是说，即使我们懂得怎么样聆听神的话，懂得怎么样操练自己，但是如果没有神，我们还是不能够往前走。
So I want to encourage everyone to not think that you are self-sufficient.
所以我要告诉你们，我们并不是靠自己能得以完全。
Don't think that it's only about what you can do that will cause you to grow spiritually mature.
不要想象就是因为我们能做什么能够让我们自己在属灵上成熟。
Do we pray for our own spiritual growth?
我们是不是能够祷告让我们自己在属灵上有成熟呢？
Do we pray for our other brothers and sisters in the church that they are growing?
我们是不是为弟兄姐妹们祷告，让他们在属灵上也能够成熟呢？
By praying, you are reminding yourself and you're reminding other people that we should depend on God.
通过祷告，我们就知道我们的属灵上的成长是要依靠神。
Now this is similar to the parable of the growing seed in Mark chapter 4.
这里有刚当耶稣的有个比喻很类似讲到。
And you see, a man can scatter seeds onto the ground.
一个人可以在地上撒种。
But then the next day, he sees that the seed sprouts and starts to grow.
过了一天，他看到这个种子发芽了。
And he doesn't know how or why that seed is growing.
他不知道这个种子究竟是怎么发芽的，但是他看到发芽了。
But the parable shows that it is not him that did anything, but rather it was God that causes the seed to sprout and grow.
这个比喻说到，他其实真正能够让种子发芽的是神。
Just like how God is helping us to grow.
好，这就像这样，就是神能够真正的帮助我们成长。
That's why we need to depend on Him.
这是为什么我们要来依靠神。
So let us review everything that we've learned from this passage.
那我们来看今天我们所学习到的，从这段经文。
So we asked this main question, what are the necessary steps to grow into spiritual maturity? And we saw that there are three steps to do so. Number one, we need to be intentional in the listening of God's word. Number two, we need to constantly practice what you hear from God's word for discernment. And finally, number three, as we just said, we need to depend solely on God for this spiritual growth.
所以今天我们来思考这个问题，就是成长到属灵成熟的必要步骤是什么。第一个，首先我们要刻意的去聆听神的话，然后在分辨是非上时常操练从神所听到的，最更重要的是能够在属灵的成长上单单来依靠神。
See, God has given us a solution for us to overcome our spiritual stagnancy.
所以神给我们指到了一个解决的方法，让我们怎么能够克服在属灵上的停滞不前。
To help us grow into maturity.
来帮助我们在属灵的成长。
So this should give us hope.
这赐给我们一个看，让我们看到有个希望。
Don't be lazy in the listening of God's word.
让我们不要在聆听神的话上很迟钝。
Don't be lazy in the constant practice of God's word.
我们在操练神的话上不要懒惰。
And most importantly, Trust that God will bring you into the man and woman that he transforms you to be.
更重要的，我们要相信神能够把你改变成你所他在他眼中所看到的男人或女人。
Do you trust that God can bring you into spiritual maturity?
你相信神能够让你在属灵上成熟吗？
And it's my prayer that we do.
这是我的祷告，应该是当然。
Let us pray.
让我们一起来祷告。
Dear Heavenly Father,
亲爱的天父，
Lord, you are our God.
主啊，你是我们的神。
And Father, we may be feeling so far away from you right now.
父啊，好像我们感觉到离你很远。
We may be feeling very stuck in our relationship with you.
好像我们感觉到有时候我们在与你的关系上我们被卡住了。
We may be feeling very, very hopeless.
我们甚至有时候感觉到我们是真是没绝望的。
But Lord, as you have shown us in your word, that there's a way to grow closer to you.
可是主啊，就看你今天向我们显示你的话，你的话也向我们显示一样，我们你给我们指到一条通向能够属灵成熟上的道路。
Father, I pray that you would convict our hearts to listen and to obey.
父啊，我请求你真是能够让我们打开我们的心门。
Help us to remember to pray for everyone in the church that you would help us grow.
让我们能够彼此的带导，也能够为弟兄姐妹带导，让我们在属灵上能够成熟。
There is nothing that can be able to stop you.
没有任何事情能够阻止。
There's no trial, there's no pain, there's no sorrow.
没有困难，也没有痛苦，没有一切的患难能够阻止。
Lord, you can overcome everything and bring us closer to you.
你让我们能够克服，让你能够让我们克服一切，让我们与你更加的接近。
And for that, we are very thankful.
这样我们非常是这样的感恩。
And Father, we would like to lift up all these things in Jesus Christ's precious and holy name.
我们这样祷告祈求，是奉主耶稣基督的圣名。
Amen.
Amen.